guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you another beautiful table runner in rectangular shape. The project is very easy to adjust to any size because during this tutorial I'm explaining how to make this project longer and how to make this project wider. If we are talking about the center part, so what I've done in blue color. Unfortunately, the number of runs for our border is staying exactly the same, so basically you've got only 6 runs of the border and the rest is the main part. So I am using hook size 1.75 millimeters and the thread similar to size 10, so 50 gram of the thread is measured about 280 meters, and my project is long about 26 inches and wide about 14. So if you are going to use similar crochet hook size, the project probably will measure the same or similar. Of course, this project we can make with a thicker yarn and the bigger hook size, so it's going to be much bigger than mine, but basically everything is up to you. So if you are new on my channel, don't forget to subscribe and we can start. My work, I am going to start by making 70 chain stitches. If we would like to make our project wider, we have to add extra 30 chain stitches or multiply of 30. And after our last 17th chain stitch, we have to make another 3 as a first double crochet. And into the 5th chain from the hook, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, we are going to make another double crochet. So chain 3 as a first double crochet, then double crochet in 4th chain from the hook, in 5th chain from the hook, and now into the next 2 stitches again, we have to make 2 double crochets. 1 and 2. Now we are going to make chain of 2 and we have to skip 2 chain stitches, 1 double crochet in next 4. 1 2 3 and 4. Chain of 2, then we have to skip next 2 chain stitches, 1 double crochet again in next 4. 1 2 3 and 4. And again, chain of 2, skip the next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, and 1 double crochet in next 4. So the same pattern now, we are going to continue to the end. At the end, in last 4 chain stitches, we should have last 4 double crochets. I've got my last 4 double crochets, so this is how the whole row looks like. And now we are going to start the second row. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet. Then we have to turn our work, another 2 chain stitches as a chain 2 space. Then we have to skip 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet in 4th double crochet. Then 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, 1 and 2. 1 double crochet in next double crochet. So this is quite similar to fillet stitch. If you will realize, we've got full square open, but instead of 3 double crochets, we've got group of 4 double crochets. Okay, so we've got group of 4 double crochets. Now chain of 2, and again we have to skip 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet into the 4th double crochet, or basically into the 30 if we are counting from the first, as we have to skip. Now 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, 1 and 2, and one double crochet in next double crochet. Then chain of two, and again we have to skip two double crochets, in next one double crochet. And this is actually our whole pattern. So now again, two double crochets in chain two space, one and two, double crochet into the double crochet, and again, chain two, skip two double crochets, one double crochet into the third double crochet. So now again, we have to continue the same pattern to the end. At the end, we have to make double crochet into the fourth double crochet from the end, chain of two, and double crochet in our last double crochet. Our third row, we are going to start again by making chain of three as the first double crochet. Then we have to turn our work, and in our chain two space, we have to make two double crochets, one and two, then double crochet into the first double crochet. So the pattern is staying similar to our previous row, because in each chain to space again we are going to make two double crochets, then double crochet in our last and first of each group. But if you will see now, we've got our four double crochets in exactly the same line as our pattern from two rows before. Chain of two, skip the next two double crochets, double crochet into the next, and again two double crochets in chain two space, then double crochet into the next double crochet, two double crochets in third double crochet, so we have to skip next two double crochets, and then two double crochets in chain two space. So the same pattern now we have to repeat to the end, and then exactly in the same way as we start row number two, we have to start by making chain of two, then double crochet, then chain of two, and next double crochet in third double crochet. And basically now we have to repeat the same pattern from row two, one and two, for as long as we want to, basically to adjust the length of our project, we have to each time add extra four rows. So for per motif on the side, we need four rows, so basically we can work for as long as we need to, but make sure that it's going to be multiply of four rows. So at the end, after the last double crochet in the row number four, we have to start exactly as row number two, then row number five as row number three, and as we can see. I'm going back to you because I told you that we have to make multiply of four rows to make our pattern, but basically I forgot to tell you that the basic is 15 rows, so we have to add a multiply of 4 to our first 15 rows. So for example, we've got 15 rows and we want to make our project bigger, we have to add 4, so 19 or 23 or 27 or 31. So multiply of 4, but we have to add this 4 to. So I am at the end of my center side. I've done 47 rows in total. At the end, we need to fasten off and cut the yarn. I'm going to start with the white thread, and basically we are going to start with the shorter side and with the right corner. So we need to insert crochet hook in our first double crochet, then we are going to make chain one, single crochet in the same double crochet, now chain of three, and one more single crochet. So this is our corner, and all corners will be exactly the same. So single crochet, chain three, and then single crochet. Now we are going to the first chain two space, and we have to make four double crochets, one, two, three, and four, chain of three, and another 4 and another 4 double crochets. 1, 2 and 3. In next 1, 2, 3 and 4. In next chain 2 space, single crochet, then chain of 3 and one more single crochet in the same chain space. So the same as we've done at the corner. In next one now, basically before we will start next one, you have to make first slip stitch into the first double crochet. So after single crochet, we need to work slip stitch in our first double crochet. Chain of 3 as a double crochet, chain 2 as a chain 2 space. Now we have to skip 2 double crochets and 1 double crochet in third one. 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, 1 and 2, and 1 double crochet into the next. Now chain of 2, skip next 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet into the third one, 2 double crochets into the chain 2 space, then double crochet in next double crochet. Now chain of 5, so the same as we've done here, chain 2 space, then 1, 2, 3 as a last double crochet. Now we have to skip 2 double crochets, slip stitch into the third, and straight away we are going to chain 2 space and we have to make single crochet, chain 3, then another single crochet and into the next chain 2 space. So now we have to skip 4 double crochets, we have to make 4 double crochets, 1, 2, 3 and 4, chain of 3, then 4 double crochets, 1, 2, 3 and 4. From now, from this part, we are going to repeat what we've done from the beginning. So in next chain space we have to make single crochet, chain 3, then another single crochet. Now slip stitch into the next double crochet, chain of 5, 3 chain stitches as a double crochet and 2 as a chain 2 space. Now we have to skip next 2 double crochets, double crochet into the third one, then 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, 1 and 2, and double crochet in next double crochet. Now chain of 2, skip 2 double crochets, 1 double crochet into the third double crochet, 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, 1 and 2, and double crochet in next double crochet. Now chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, skip 2 double crochets, slip stitch into the third one, then in chain 2 space we have to make single crochet, chain 3 and then single crochet, and in last one 4 double crochets, 1, 2, 3 and 4, chain of 3 and another 4 double crochets, 1, 2, 3 and 4. At the corner we have to make exactly what we've done from the beginning. So single crochet, chain 3 and one more single crochet. So one more time. If you've got more chain stitches, basically you after this part you have to repeat what we've done here again. So this is our part. We've got a shell, then chain 3 space, then we've got 1, 2, 3 open squares, 2 full squares, no, again chain 3 and again shell. And now the longer side is going to look a little bit different. So each corner We are working exactly the same way, so single crochet, chain three, and single crochet. And now we have to go to the first row with open square. And again, four double crochets, one, two, three, and four. Chain of three, then another four double crochets, one, two, three, and four. And now we have to skip row with four double crochets into the next one with open square, single crochet, chain three, and again single crochet. Then again, we have to skip row with four double crochets. So each time this row we have to skip. And we need to make four double crochets. One, two, three, and four. Chain three, then another four double crochets. One, two, three, and four. And again, skip four double crochets in next open square, single crochet, chain three, then one more single crochet. So on our longer side, the pattern looks a little bit different. So we have to first work four double crochets, chain three, and four double crochets in next one, single crochet, chain three, single crochet, and then again. Of course, at the end of our row, we should, our side, we should have the last group of four double crochets. Then we have to work our corner, single crochet, chain three, single crochet in our first double crochet. And we have to, on our next shorter side, we repeat what we've done here. And then on the opposite side, on the longer side, again, what we are doing now. Now we are going to start second round. So after slip stitch in our first single crochet, I'm going to make slip stitch into the first chain stitch, then into the chain three space. We have to make chain of four. Maybe I will make a little bit closer. Chain of four as a first treble crochet, then chain two as a chain two space. Now into the same chain three space, treble crochet, chain two, and again treble crochet. So at the beginning we've got three treble crochets and two chain two spaces, but in total we should have four. So at the end we need to add extra one treble crochet. Now we are going directly to the chain three space. We are on our shorter side and we have to make eight treble crochets. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Now, in our chain two space, we have to make single crochet, chain three, and another single crochet. But now chain one, and we have to make slip stitch into the third chain, so basically into the top of the double crochet from our previous round. Now chain of three as a double crochet and two double crochets in chain two space, one and two. One double crochet into the first double crochet, then chain of two, then we have to skip next two double crochets and one double crochet into the third one. And again, we have to make two double crochets in chain two space, one and two, then double crochet in next double crochet. Chain of two, then again, we have to skip two double crochets, double crochet into the third one, then two double crochets in chain space, one and two. And now, instead of the next double crochet, we have to make chain of three, and we have to make slip stitch, one, two, in third chain stitch from the from the bottom, so basically on the top of our double crochet. Now chain one, single crochet in chain three space, chain three, and one more single crochet. So the chain one spaces before and after single crochet we are working only when we have to make chain three instead of the double crochet at the beginning and at the end. So before we've got chain one and after we've got chain one. Now, without any chain stitches, we are going directly to the chain three space, and again we need to make 8 treble crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Single crochet in next chain three space, then chain of three, single crochet in the same chain three space. Now chain one, and again slip stitch into the third chain stitch, chain of three as a double crochet, then two double crochets in chain two space, one and two, and now we have to make double crochet into the next double crochet, chain of two, so the same as we've done with the first one. We have to skip two double crochets, one double crochet into the third one, then two double crochets in chain two space, and one double crochet into the double crochet. Chain two, skip the next two stitches, double crochet into the third, then two double crochets in chain two space, and instead of the last double crochet, chain of three, and slip stitch into the third chain. One, two, and three. Chain one, single crochet in chain three space, chain of three, single crochet in the same chain three space, and now we have to go directly to chain three and we need to make another 8 treble crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And we've got our corner again. So in chain three space, treble crochet, chain two. And again, treble crochet, chain two, treble crochet chain two, and one more treble crochet. So we've got 4 treble crochets and 3 chain two spaces. So as I said before, at the end we have to add extra treble crochet and chain two. Now we are going to the longer side and we have to start by making 8 treble crochets in first chain three space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now, without any chain stitches, we are going to the chain free space, but this time on the longer side we need to work treble crochet, chain 2, and another treble crochet. So on our shorter side we have to work single crochet, chain 3, and single crochet, but here we've got treble crochet, chain 2, and treble crochet. Then we have to go to the next chain 3 space and 8 treble crochets again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Then in chain 3 space treble crochet, chain 2, and treble crochet. So now we need to make exactly the same to the end of this side. Then we need to repeat what we've done at the corner and start working on the shorter side in exactly the same as we've done from the beginning. So we've got full square on the top of open one and open on the top of the full. 8 treble crochets in each chain 3 space. So at the end, of course, we have to add extra treble crochet and then chain 2. Now we are going to start round number 3. So at the end, I've done the last treble crochet and chain 2, then slip stitch into the top of chain 4. Now chain of 4 as a treble crochet again, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space. In our chain 2 space now, we have to work treble crochet, chain of 2, and another treble crochet. Chain of 2, then 1 treble crochet in next treble crochet. So we've done in first, in second treble crochet, then in chain 2 space and into the third one. Now chain 1, or actually we can work chain of 2, and we have to make 1 double crochet in next 8 treble crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now chain of 3, and we have to go to the chain 3 space. Single crochet, chain 3, and another single crochet. Chain of 2, then on the top of our 3 chain stitches we have to make single crochet, and now chain of 2, and we are going to the space between 2 double crochets. So we've got group of 4 double crochets after first open square, and now we are going to make 9 quadruple treble crochet. So we need to yarn over 4 times and let's start. So our work, basically we need to work very very tight. After each quadruple treble crochet we have to make chain of 2 and again. Very very tight. Chain of 2 and again. Chain of 2 chain of two. So after each quadruple treble crochet chain of two, and we have to make 9 of them. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six, seven, eight, and one more. And 9. After the last one, chain of 2, then we have to skip the last 2 double crochets, open square, and the next 3, and single crochet into the 3rd chain stitch of the last double crochet before next chain 3. So the same we've done at the beginning. We have to skip 3 double crochets, open square, now open square, and 3 double crochets. Chain of 2. In chain 3 space, single crochet, chain of 3, and again single crochet. Now chain 3, then into the next 8 treble crochets, we have to make 1 double crochet in each. So exactly the same as we just start. So after the last one, we have to work chain 3, then again single crochet, chain 3, and single crochet in chain 3 space, chain 2, single crochet in 3rd chain stitch, into the space between 4 double crochets in the middle, we have to make 9 quadruple treble crochets between chain 2 spaces until the next group of 8 treble crochets. Here we have to make 1 double crochet as we've done then, and I will go back to you at the beginning of next corner. So now I'm exactly at the corner. I've done my last 8 double crochets, then chain 2 space, and at the corner we have to repeat what we've done before. So we need to skip 1st treble crochet, 1 treble crochet into the 2nd one, chain of 2, treble crochet into the chain 2 space, chain 2, then treble crochet in the same chain 2 space, then chain of 2, and treble crochet into the 3rd treble crochet. So we've got treble crochet in 2nd treble crochet, then 2 treble crochets in a space between 2nd and 3rd, and the last one into the 3rd. Now chain of 2, or actually start our round, so chain of 2, and now we have to make 1 double crochet in each treble crochet, so quite similar. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 7 and 8. This is our longer side now. So we had treble crochet, chain 2, and treble crochet in our previous round. Now we have to make chain of 2, and into the next group of 8 treble crochets, we have to work 1 double crochet in each again. 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, and 8. Chain of 2 again, then we are going to the next group, and 8 double crochets again. So now we have to continue to the end of our round, then make another corner. We'll repeat what we've done on our shorter side and work slip stitch into the top of chain 4 of our 1st treble crochet at the corner, and then I will show you what we have to do in next round. Now we are going to start round 4 of our border, and after slip stitch into the top of chain 4, now we need to make chain of 5, So instead of double treble crochet, then chain of two as a chain two space into the next treble crochet, we have to work double treble crochet. Chain of two into the chain space after the second treble crochet, we have to work double treble crochet again. Chain two and one more double treble crochet in the same chain space. Chain two, double treble crochet in next treble crochet. Chain of two, then double treble crochet in last treble crochet at our corner. So now we've got one double treble crochet in each treble crochet from previous round, and into the center chain two space we also have done V-stitch. So double treble crochet, chain two and double treble crochet. So the same pattern we have to repeat at each corner. Now chain of two. And we are going directly to the group of our 8 double crochets. Now we have to make 1 double crochet in each stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So now we've got 8 double crochets, then chain of 2, and we are going directly to the group of 9 quadruple treble crochets. In each one, now we have to work double treble crochet again. So we, after chain of 2, we are going to the first one. Chain of 2, maybe not in each one, in first 4. Then double treble crochet in next. Chain of two, double treble crochet in third. Chain of two, double treble crochet into the fourth. Chain of two, and into the fifth we have to work double treble crochet again. Chain of two, and one more double treble crochet in the same stitch. So into the center one we have to work V-stitch. Double treble crochet, chain two and another double treble crochet. Now chain of two again. Double treble crochet in next stitch, in next quadruple treble crochet. Chain of two, double treble crochet in next one. Chain of two, double treble crochet in next. Chain of two, double treble crochet into the next. So now we've got 10 double treble crochets because we've done extra one in our fifth quadruple treble crochet. Then we have to make chain of two, and now we need to skip chain three spaces and we are going directly to the next group of 8 double crochets and 1 double crochet in each. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now chain of two, and we have to repeat what we've done with double treble crochets before. So we have to make this once more time on if you've got a wider if your pattern is wider, so as many times as you need to, then chain of 2 and 8 double crochets into the last group of 8 double crochets, then chain of 2, and we have to repeat what we've done at the corner from the beginning of our round in exactly the same way, then chain of 2, and we have to go to the our longer side to groups of 8 double crochets. The pattern is staying exactly the same, so we have to make 1 double crochet in each double crochet, then chain of 2 as we've done here, 1 double crochet in each double crochet, then chain of 2. So we have to finish the shorter side, then make the longer, and another time we have to work shorter side in exactly the same way and then longer. At the end we need to work slip stitch into the top of chain 5 from the beginning. Now we are going to start round number 5, so again we need to make chain of 5, 3, 4, 5 instead of our first double treble crochet. Now chain of 2 as a chain 2 space. Now double treble crochet into the next double treble crochet, chain of 2, then again double treble crochet in next one, chain 2. Now we should have the center chain space, so in this center space we have to work double treble crochet again, chain of 2 and double treble crochet in the same chain 2 space. So we've got some kind of V-stitch, double treble crochet, chain 2 and double treble crochet in one chain space. Then again chain of 2, double treble crochet into the next stitch, chain of 2, then double treble crochet into the next, and double treble crochet into the next. Now we have to make chain of 2 and we've got group of 8 double crochets. So 1 double crochet into the next 3 stitches. 1, 2 and 3. Then chain of 2. Then and we have to skip next 2 stitches in the last 3 1 double crochet. 1, 2 and 3. From now we have to make chain of 2 and repeat what we've done in our, maybe not even what we've done, the stitches, what we've done in our round number 3. I told you that we had to make quadruple treble crochet, but basically I just realized that because of we need to yarn over 4 times, it is triple treble crochet. So we have to make triple treble crochet again in our first double treble crochet. Then, but basically I forgot, we have to skip the first one and we need to make chain of 3 and we are going directly to the second one. So after the last double crochet, chain of 3 and triple treble crochet in second double treble crochet, then chain of 2, double treble crochet in next, chain of 2, triple treble crochet in next, chain of 2, triple treble crochet in next, and now we've got the center stitch, the center chain 2 space, and we have to make a V stitch by working triple treble crochets in that chain 2 space. So triple treble crochet, chain of 2 and triple treble crochet in the same chain space. Chain of 2, then triple treble crochet into the stitch just after this chain two space. Chain of two into the next stitch, triple treble crochet, chain of two into the next stitch, triple treble crochet, chain of two, triple treble crochet in next stitch. And now chain of three. So the last double treble crochet we have to skip. So on our right side where we've done V stitch, we've got four, and on the left side as well, four triple treble crochets. Chain of three, and we have to repeat one double crochet in next three stitches. One, two, and three. I missed the first one. One, two, and three. Chain of two, and then one, then we have to make chain of two, skip two double crochets, and again make one double crochet in last three stitches. So as we've done before, one double crochet in first three, then chain of two, and one double crochet in last three. The middle two double crochets we have to skip, and now chain of three again, then we have to repeat this part. So don't forget to skip the first one and the last double treble crochet, and then you have to finish the same pattern to the end of this short side. So basically on the second one I've got the last group of eight double crochet and then my corner. So after the last double crochet we have to make chain of two and repeat what we've done at the corner. So just go back to the beginning, and on our longer side basically the pattern with eight double crochets is staying exactly the same. So one double crochet in first three, chain of two, then we have to skip two double crochets, and then one double crochet in last three, chain of two, and we have to repeat all the way across to the next corner. So this is our whole pattern. So each group of eight double crochet it looks exactly the same. So now we are going to start the last one, round number 6. After slip stitch in our double treble crochet, now we have to make slip stitch in chain 3 space, chain 1 and single crochet. Then in the same chain space we have to make another 2 single crochets, 1 and 2. Now chain of 4, slip stitch into the fourth chain stitch from the hook, chain one, and into the next chain space three single crochets again, one, two, and three, and again chain of four, slip stitch in fourth chain from the hook, then chain one and three single crochets in next chain space, one, two, and three. After third single crochet, chain of four, slip stitch in fourth chain from the hook, chain one, and three single crochets in next chain space, one, two, and three, chain of four, one, two, three, four. Slip stitch into the fourth chain from the hook, chain one, and 3 single crochets in next chain space. So basically the same pattern is in each chain space. Sometimes you've got chain 2, sometimes you've got chain 3. All the time you need to make 3 single crochets in each, and then after third single crochet we need to work picot. So I'm going to the end because I would like to show you here our pattern is going to look a little bit different. And basically all the way around in each chain space we have to work exactly the same pattern. As I am doing now. After each picot, chain 1 and then 3 single crochets. Now we've got the last chain space before group of 3 double crochets, chain 2 and another 3 double crochets. So then we need, after the third single crochet, we need to make 1 single crochet in next 2 double crochets. So we are not working any picots. And we are going to the chain 2 space. Now we need to make a double crochet. Then picot by making chain of 4 and slip stitch on the top of the double crochet. Then again, double crochet, slip stitch on the top of the double crochet, double crochet again, then chain 4 and slip stitch on the top of the double crochet. So we've got 1, 2, 3, now 4, then 5. We need to work 6 double crochets, but only after the first 5 we need to work picot. So we should have 5 picots, then 6 double crochet, still in the same chain space. So 6 double crochets, 5 picots, and then we have to skip first double crochet, 1 double crochet in next 2, 1 and 2. Then we've got again another chain spaces, so we need to go back and work exactly the same as we've done here. And the same pattern we need to continue all the way around. So in each chain 2 space between 2 groups of 3 double crochets we have to work 6 double crochets and 5 picots, and in each chain space we need to work 3 single crochets, and between chain spaces we need to make picot. So basically at the end we have to make slip stitch in our first single crochet and our work will be done. So thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial. Oh, actually I forgot. When we've got chain 2 spaces between 2 groups, we are working only 3 single crochets without picot, so the pattern is staying quite similar to the last chain space before 3 double crochets. So thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial and see you in the next one. Have a nice day!